In this tutorial, we will evolve the previous project. We will let the final user to select how many compressors he wants to use. As a first step, we can split this mask that shows the status of the compressor in four different masks, four masks, one for each compressor. Then we can create a new mask in a new loop, where the final user can select how many compressors he wants, and then we have to enable the compressors. Enable means two things. The first is to enable the mask, that is let the final user enter in a mask, for example the mask showing the status of the compressor 4, only if there are at least 4 compressors used. And then we have also to enable the compressor relay, that is, for example, switch on the compressor 4, not only according to the temperature, but also according to the enable of the compressor. Well, let's start from here. So now we have to split this mask in 4. Now there are different ways to do this. We could copy and paste 3 times this one and delete what is not used, or delete and create 4 masks from scratch, or we can do this. I prefer to we can start renaming the mask compressor status 1. Delete the variables that are not used for the compressor 1, and then we can duplicate this, copy and paste. It's better to click where we want to paste. Here is click and paste here, so not necessary to move. Okay, now we can rename the mask first. This is 2. This is 2. This is compressor 2. Well, the same for the other 2 masks. Now we have to create a configuration mask where the final user can select how many compressors he wants. So we can create a new mask. No, we can start from a loop and then a mask. Okay, it's already connected. Rename. This is loop configuration, and this could be mask configuration. And then we can create a variable representing the number of compressors. Well, this is what happened or what you can find in a common application. Just a number, for example, in this case from 1 to 4, that is the number of the compressors. But in this exercise, I prefer to create 4 different Boolean variables for each compressors. Why this? Because these 4 variables are, let's say, propedeutic for the next exercises. So we can create the variables. You know how to do this. So go back in the strategy, in the global variables. We don't need it. And then create a new variable. Boolean is good. The variable, a good name, is enable compressor 1. Read write, this is good. But by the way, this should be read only. So enable compressor 1 is read write, because we want to change the value in the mask and maybe also in other editors. Retain, yes, because we don't want to lose the selection, the choice after a blackout. And visible also in the UI, user interface, and finally the description. Enable compare. So one. Now we have to create the other three variables. There are two possibilities. One, you know, but probably you remember, is the quick declaration using as a prefix enable comp and from 2 to 4 because we already have number 1 and okay and setting the other flags. But this time I will maybe easier copy and paste. So just change here, change the description 2, 3, 4. Well, all other properties are good. Now, in order to see this variable in the other editors, maybe you remember that we have at least save. Sooner or later we have to build, but for now is enough save. So here now we have the four variables. So we can start describing the variables with a normal text. The point here is how to describe this parameter. I prefer to use this way. Compressor 1 enable. Maybe that you prefer different description, but also in this case I prefer to use this way to describe the parameter because this is suitable for the next exercises. Well, compressor 1 enable. And then the variable. We use the variable and we can use the filter. En and here is. So this is enable compressor 1, input output boolean. Okay. Repeat the same for other 3, but I prefer obviously to copy and paste. And then change just the number. 2 here, 2 here, and the same for the other 2 variables. Okay, this is enable compressor 1, 2, 2, 3, and 4. Now we have to enable the object or the function of the 4 compressors. The first is here in mask, that is we have to enable, as I told you before, for example, this mask, the one regarding the compressor 4, only if the compressor 4 is enabled. So to do this, there is a property of the mask. So remember, first click the mask, and then you can edit the property. Is enable on. In the enable on you can specify one or more boolean variables, and when all the value of all variables is 1, then the mask is enabled, that is the user can enter on it. So in this case we need just one variable, so this is the mask for compressor 3. So here we have to write or select from the list, from the using the support window, we have to select the variable 3. So this is enable compressor 3. We don't need this, so you can see that we can select one or more variables. Well, this is compressor 3, this is for the compressor 4, this is for the compressor 2, and the compressor 1. Probably you are wondering why to enable compressor 1, because we should have at least one compressor, but I preferred to do the same for all for consistency for all 4 compressors. So let's check enable compressor 1, 2, 3, and 4. That is compressor 1, comp 1, can be one through, not only according to the temperature, but also according to the enable compressor. So I will start, so we have to edit this part. So the easiest way to implement what I told you is using a new block, very simple block. Here is the block library. The name of the block is one in the standard library, is end. Here is. So compressor 1 depends not only by the stage 1, that is according to the temperature, but also according to the variable global enable compressor 1. I need to make some space. The same for the other 3. Copy and paste or control move to duplicate this compressor 2, this is enable compressor 2, and this is the stage 2, and the same for the other 2 compressors. I already changed the name of variables, so just change the path of the connection. Enable compressor 1, 2, 3, 4, compressor 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, it's all for the modification in the mask and in the strategy. Now we can test this modification. For simulation, let's wait and be sure that there are no errors, as I can't simulate mask and strategy together. Okay, no errors. Go back in mask. We can build. Would go straight to simulation, because when you start simulation, the debugging, it automatically build. Well, build. Okay, zoom out. Well, if you don't see the variable here, you can, or even worse, if you don't see list, you can click variable, watch variables, we can load the old current variables. We can see that the enable compressor 1234 are off, so we have to set it to 1 just to check if the compressor start. So now we can enter in the configuration mask, and probably now you are wondering how to enter in the configuration mask, because we didn't define any key to do this, to enter in the configuration mask. We can do it right now. So stop for a while the simulation, go back here. So in the previous exercises we have used ESC and PRG button to enter respectively here in the loop main and loop setting. Now we can use another key to enter in this in the new loop. Well, we can't use a single key, because the up, down, enter keys are used to change the variables, the value of the variables in the screen, or also change the mask. ESC PRG are already used for the to enter here, and here the alarm key is used for the alarms that we will see in the next exercises, so we can't use a single key. In this exercise we will use a key combination, that is ESC and PRG pressed together. Well, in this list you can see that there are the single keys. So now we have to create a key, a couple of keys using this button. We can create a shortcut. The single keys are enter and PRG. Enter PRG or PRG enter is exactly the same thing, there is no difference. So here we have a new name that behaves exactly like others. So like before, we have to create as a first step the function to bind with this. So if you remember, we have to create here in the code a new function. I could copy and paste the previous one and change, but I prefer to write from scratch. So control space, just to help to find the name of the keyword. So the function terminal key, I use the same style of before, terminal key, enter PRG. Control space, go to loop, open parenthesis, the name of the loop configuration, control space, and function, no semicolon, here not necessary. So the terminal key enter PRG, go to loop. Loop configuration, is correct. Now we have to bind this function to the key, this key. If you remember, before to select the name of the function, we have to select the terminal level. Later you will understand why we have to select the terminal. And here is enter PRG, the name of the new function, terminal key, enter PRG. Okay, that's all. So PRG enter in the set point mask, setting mask, ask in the main mask, and enter PRG, that is called the program here, enter in the configuration mask. We can see also from here that all variables are zero. We can change as usual using up, down, enter. You can see that are changing also the mask watch. Well, this is the, let's say, the same condition of the previous exercise, that is all compressor enabled. So I expect first of all to see there is all four masks, compressor 1, 2, 3, 4, and also I expect that the compressor starts if the temperature is high enough. I can see that the set point is 0, so I can change from here 12 degrees, differential 4 degrees, sì. Temperature very high, 16, in fact here is all 4 compressors are on, 1, 2, 3 and 4. We can see this, we can check this also in the strategy. So if we switch to see strategy and simulation, we can start the simulation. Okay, now the program is running. So temperature very high, so all four stages are true, all compressors are enabled, so that also the four compressors are active. Okay, now we can check what happened if we disable the compressors. So enter again the configuration mask, let's disable the last one, the compressor 4. So we expect two things. First is not to be able to enter in the mask of the fourth compressor. 1, 2, 3. In fact, the mask for the fourth compressor is invisible, so this works. Second, we expect that also the compressor relay is off. The evidence is here, because the variable representing the status of compressor 4 is off or 0. Also here, we can check it, there is. Okay, and continue with other tests, so we can disable compressor 3, so we should see only 1 and 2, factor 1 and 2. Compressor 3 is forced off, we can see here and we can see also here. And then we can also do it here. We can disable the compressor 2. And here is the compressor 2 has been switched forced off. Very last does make sense, but we can disable also the compressor number 1. You see, if you click up and down, we can see the masks of four compressors. All compressors are forced off, and also here we can check this. Here we have, you see here, through. We have the cooling demand, but the compressors are off because of the enable. Just another some words regarding this this thing. Let me enable again this. So if you remember, we have used these variables, the variables used here in these four classes, to enable these four masks. So the up down keys, as written here, shows the previous and next mask that is enabled. So in this example, if we are in this mask and we press the key down, but this mask is disabled, we will see the next one. Well, that's all for this tutorial, where we have seen how to enable a device. In this in this case were compressors, but with this, in the same way you can enable the condensing fans, how many condensing fans there are used, or how many heaters. We have seen how to enable a mask, so make it visible or not, and how to enable a, let's say, a relay, like the compressor 1, 2, 3, 4. Technically speaking, we have seen three or four new things. The first is the enable on property at mask level. We have seen how to create a shortcut like this, enter PRG, and then we have seen a new block, that is the end block. Before to close this tutorial, I can show you another feature, that is how to change the sequence of the mask. That is something that I mentioned also in the previous tutorial. For example, how is possible to move, probably it's not a real case, but how to move this mask, the input mask, here in the middle. So the way is to just change the connection between the masks. For example, here I can delete this connection. Probably if you zoom is better. Okay, this connection, move this one here, delete also this connection and reconnect them. So, when we press the key ESC, and the key ESC executes the terminal key ESC, and the terminal key ESC go to the loop main, in this case, loop main, it will show the first mask as usual of that loop, that is comp status 1. And pressing key down, it will enter in this one, and then this, and the other, and so on. In the same way, we can also move masks in another loop. For example, we can do this. Well, and then we have moved. It is a little mess. Well, we moved two masks in another loop. So in this last part we have seen how to change the sequence of the mask in a loop. Now I will restore the sequence, the original sequence. Here is back the original sequence. Well, this is really all for this tutorial. In the next one we will improve and evolve even more this one.